The worst news that a school administrator or a school superintendent can receive is a phone call telling you that you've had a student pass away. I received that phone call Sunday.
A sudden illness claims the life of a young boy. What his school district is doing to protect other children. Good evening, everyone. Larry's off tonight. The community of Oak Grove continues to mourn tonight after the death of an 11-year-old boy.
But just what killed Jordan Smith is still a giant question mark. KMBC 9's Peggy Breit is live in Oak Grove with our top story. Peggy?
Kelly, Jordan was an energetic fifth grader here at this elementary school. He was apparently feeling fine early last week. On Monday and Tuesday, he was here. Then he got sick, and by Sunday, it was too late.
I recorded a message informing everybody of the situation and that we would have a support team in place on Monday morning for those students that needed help.
It was the first step Freddie Doherty took as superintendent of Oak Grove Schools. But the parents of other students want to know if H1N1 is what caused Jordan's death. This is the superintendent's answer.
At this time, we do not know the official cause of this boy's death.
A relative tells us Jordan was taken to an Independence hospital on Saturday, then flown to Children's Mercy, where he died. The school district was already prepared for a bad flu season, already had the custodial staff disinfecting everything.
All hard surfaces that come in contact with your hands, the doorknobs, the desk, you know, the restrooms.
Every night,
yes.
So if the H1N1 flu virus is what Jordan had, the school district won't change what it's doing. But administrators will remember the price paid here in Oak Grove.
You can take all the precautions that you've been told to take, and sometimes the worst still happens.
Coming up tonight at 6, how children here are being taught to whack the flu and some surprising numbers about illnesses here in the Oak Grove District. We're live in Oak Grove. Back to you in the studio, Kelly.
Peggy, when do they expect to know the cause of death?
Well, the Jackson County Health Department isn't telling us that. They're only saying that tests are underway to determine the cause.
All right. Thank you, Peggy. And the memorial service for 11-year-old Jordan Smith is scheduled for this Friday.